start feeling a bit emotional. Now it's going to be more, I think. I wanted to show you a picture which is made by a 10-year-old child after a visit to a primary school where my sister is a teacher in. He gave a speech presentation there. It was about international cultures, different cultures. So it was like half an hour, maybe a bit more, speech he gave to 10 years old children. So of course, the ones who knew him can imagine how the speech was so colorful, joyful, and full of information, different informations, and interesting informations, of course. So children were amazed about his speech. So when he finished, one of the students drew this picture, this caricature, let's say. So she could understood in half an hour how Professor Koshinova was a colorful person, how he was special. So here you see he is like a magician. He's more than a professor or more than a teacher. He has a hat in his hand and the rabbit is coming out, so this is a surprise. So Professor Koshinova was always full of surprises. He always surprised us with interesting ideas and concepts he brought us. So he was really an interesting and special person for all of us. He was like a member of our family. He was more than a friend or more than a professor for all of us. He also opened a gate to his school, to Instituto Superior Técnico. We had made lots of friends from his colleagues, and he opened his house, his family. So it was a special relationship we developed with him. I knew him since 1992 when I started to work here in this department after I was graduating as a research assistant.
Just a few words, because after the presentation, you kept very, very well the spirit, the ideas, and also the strengths of Kosovo. One of the things that we learned with him is that he was a man of fights, but he knows exactly to choose what is the good moment to take a good fight, because you have to be, he used very much some analogy with the cat. The cat is very soft and thick, but if he found the good moment, he'd take it. And I think you kept very well what are his concepts, ideas, how he was pioneer in a lot of things. I have finished with some of my colleagues now. We are trying to put in a kind of a paper or something like that some of their projects along their life that they were quite innovative at the time. And we found one when I and Anton Ferrero were when we are assistants, not yet professors, and with him in a small town 100 kilometers south of Lisbon. And when I revisited these sketches and works of an urban plan, and the urban plan is it was developed in the mid-80s and finished around the beginning of 1970, something like that. And for the first time, they used the concept of a planning unit, planning and management unit. So at that time, we don't use anymore the zoning plan that was in the, everybody do it, but he defined what he called planning and management unit. So he decided to see what are the guidelines for the development of that area, and then work with the people and work with developers and municipalities and population to realize and to design after the discussion. That is very interesting, because the regulation of the plan is when page A4. And after that, we have to develop that in a more legal framework form. But it's interesting to see now, after 30 years later, that the great majority of the guidelines was accomplished in that time. And I think that is one of the aspects more interesting, that is, as he was very no-communist. He's not a person that put like a wow, it's a Greek, I cannot do that, never. And he has that capacity to develop new ideas, very attached to the reality. He's not a speculative thinker. It's always his preoccupation, as you mentioned, very human, human feelings and human values. So it was very concentrated with people and how it would be. I think that we have a tremendous obligation with it, is to continue the cooperation between our schools. I think that is the most important thing. Because in our generation that we meet him and we work with him, that is quite clear. But for the younger generations, we have to show them how important could be this experience to share in these two countries. Because people today are much more focused in the short term, in the short gains, in the to obtain some credits for something like that. And these kind of experience is something that you you enjoy it in the short term, because Lisbon is very nice, Istanbul is very nice, people are nice, so you really enjoy it. You have to experience it first to understand them. But the results, the majority of the results is the results of medium and long term. You become with a much more open mind, and you become to understand much more why planning fails so much. Because you work much more is the challenge that I feel that we have to work to maintain this kind of cooperation, to create more conditions for students from those countries who didn't work in our universities and, of course, academics. And thank you very much, Casper, for remembering that. Yeah, thank you very much.
This speech is a very informal speech because I will not prepare the very ordered presentation. So just, how can I say, this is the presentation for our emotional pictures, how can I say. So it's a symbolic and the characteristic pictures what we have under the Kosovo memories. So the important things from my memory, I can say a lot of things about his academic way of thinking, but it's not enough to understand totally him. So if you ask my family members, or if you ask to our generations, everybody understands that Kosovo is our grandfather. The grandfather typology is very important for our memories. For this reason, I can show some pictures from the academic part of this relations, and also some emotional part of this relations. I met him in 1996, the first visit to Lisbon from our university. It's a good relationship between the Lisbon Technical University and the Marsan. And as a student, a PhD student, we were in the Lisbon together as a group of us. Nearly 1 year later, in 1999, we had a cooperation between the two universities. At that time, it was no Erasmus. Nearly the 2002, the Erasmus will start. Then after that, we made the bilateral agreement between the two universities. But at that time, during the 3 or 4 years, we used the bilateral cooperation together. In every picture, you will see the Kosovo in different different shape and different typology. This is the first agreement on our university's council, and they are signing the bilateral agreement between the two institutions. And you can see the Kosovo is always thinking and always writing, always busy. And I surprised him always. What is the meaning of surprising? He always a good dress, but sometimes he's going to the council, the university, making appointment, and also he can visit the area with you, and he can walk very rapidly, and he is a very sport dressed. How is it possible? So in one minute, he has a bow tie, and he's just in the pocket, he like bow tie, and he's going to the rector, and he's just solving the bow tie, he's going to the area with you, and he's a very, very clever man in my mind. And we have a good memories with him. Always we have a good meals, lunch, dinners. Because I said to you, yes, that's the reason. We have a good academic relations, but also the good emotional way of living, how can I say. You can see the picture, everybody is smiling, and very young generations. Yeah, we were in the somewhere in the Turkey. This is the entrance of the Hasan Cave in the south part of Turkey. As a group of Mimarsan and some students from the Dicle University, different university, and you can see all the groups, all the students knows Kosovo, and he's not an academic. Not only the academics, he's also the grandfather because he's keeping his hands to the others. Always he's describing, explaining. He's jogging, he's doing everything. So he's a very good, how can I say, the personal, emotional quality. And this is the first bilateral agreement from our university. And the, under the Erasmus cooperation, we made some different academic cooperations. But after 2006, we went to Coimbra, his third place. And we tried to visit his home and his family members. But after this trip, every student understands Kosovo is a magician, yes. He's a magician because he's living in a castle. And this is the cooperation in Coimbra municipality, and there are some presentation session, some working session. In this picture shows us he's very good person for listening also. He's speaking, but also he's listening to all. Always he's listening to the students, teachers, and he criticizes the students under the planning approaches. You can get more information during this process. This is very important in my mind. And he's a very colorful person. Can you find the Kosparova? He's taking the photo on the right. he's always but the colorful personality, I think this is symbolized in when we are working in the workshop time, he is very good emotional things and he loves the works and he says, okay, that's the time for music and for dance and the Turkish dance also. And we found a CD and he made the Turkish dance together. All the students and the things. I have the video for that one, but I just the picture this case. And from his car in his house in Coimbra. And he asked us, can you see the pictures on the desk? Things, and for example, this one. And who is he and where is he? Like that. He's the grandfather of Kosparova and he was in jail, for example. Surprise. And also the another things, can you see that this part and who is he and what is he doing? And he is a professor in the Coimbra University in astrophysics. And his grandfather of Kosparova. So I surprised him because this corner is very interesting for me and all the students. And really, it's a castle, and to understand his family relations. You can see the son of Kosparova on the right things, and yeah, some students and the Kosparova together. And he encouraged us to visit the others in the Lisbon Technical University, and we have a good friends from Lisbon. I really appreciate to CESUR and the Marsina University Cooperation, we met a lot of persons and we had a very, very good friends from Portugal. Thanks to him and thanks to you. And I have some friends also from Sintra, Paula. And he always visit. He can read and he can speak, but he says, okay, that's the unreal things. We have to touch the real things. We can go to the area together. We can walk. Go. He says always like that, and he always walk around. So I really thanks to him to encourage us to visit the real world. So this is the one of the picture from the Coimbra garden, and this is from the Antwerp. I try to follow him, but you can't because he's very, very active, and he's somewhere in Malaysia, sometimes in UK. In the United States, you cannot find him. And sometimes we found him and worked together in the case from the ISOCAP Congress in 2007 and 2000 in Belgium. And I will remember him like these pictures, and also I will remember him his kind of drawings. This is the one drawings in this university for the Green Age Symposium, and we invite him to conference. Present a Green Age idea, and he's drawing very symbolic caricatures, and he's drawing very simple planning approaches and some additional things from him. And I think that's the last pictures of my informal presentation to you. Thank you very much.
Professor Kostolou, since 1975. It was my teacher in the university, and they teach me urbanism. We had two disciplines that was designated by urbanization one and urbanization two. It teach me this two disciplines. And I can say that it can cultivate me for these subjects. And when I finish my graduate school, graduate, he invited me to integrate the research center in 76, a lot of years ago. And I had the privilege to work with him in the research center, but not only, in real projects, as Fernando presents here. To Wenders Nowers. I work with him also in its atelier in the beginning of my career, and I entered also to the university. I was invited to be assistant, and I shared with him after that the teaching of several of disciplines in civil engineering course. It has been a privilege for me to have this master. Really, I can say that it teaches me to be engineering, it teaches me to be a researcher, it teaches me to be a professional, it teaches me to be a teacher. And I must say to Costello, thank you, Professor. Let's say that the minimum that I think that we can do in its memory is to increase this collaboration with this university that it loves so much. I have a lot of conversation with him, and we discuss a lot of things. And one of the things was the relationship between the Portuguese university and the Turkish university. Another thing that was very, very important to discuss, and it didn't complete the personality of Costa Law, it was discussing the values, it was not the solution, it was not what is important, is the equity for the learners, the equity, the transparency, the competence. This is very, very, very important. I had a lot of discussion with him about this aspect and the importance of this in the activity of urbanism. Okay, I think we must increase and develop this relationship between Lisbon and Turkey and these universities. I want only to finish sharing with you a very special situation where in the only time that I saw Costa Lobo with a faster answer to the situation. Let me say, I was making some oral examination with him. We have here seated in front of us a set of three women. It was students that were women. And usually the system asked the number of the people to put the graduate in the paper. However, I have a terrible problem because I see here the number and I write here and I ask always to Costello, please professor, do you this service, because I have this problem of eyes and I would like that you do this. Okay, no problem. And Costello asked to the first of her, please, you are a number. And she told, the phone number, professor. Okay, thank you for the invitation.
always trying to show us
point of view. Did you see that? Did you see that? Did you recognize that? This image, matrix, and meaning. And in the beginning, I never think about matrix, meaning, image. And he always said, and if you want to be a helper, healer of the city, or as a citizen of the city, you need to learn how to measure. First, from yourself. Start from yourself. How is your length of your hands? And how long your steps? How high your steps? And how many times you... how many times you breathe while you are running? How many times you stop when you are staying down? And it's always there. And you never make any distinction between his life being a father, his life being a planner, his life being a child, his life being a professor. You never feel that he has a professor while you are walking. You never feel that he is a professor while you are climbing. He never think that he is older than you, around 50 years older than you, and he's always climbing up. But he is a small tricks, and sometimes when he feel himself a little bit tired, in the middle of the mountain, in the middle of the stairs, and stop there, don't forget to look at the small things. And he just pick one flower there, and then he starts looking at that one, and he explained the feelings of that smallest things in the earth. And he never say stop, he always say try again. And that was the last photo, and he wrote that posters in the, he put the special notes on it. This poster prepared by two nights, 24 hours, and by handmade. And he always thinking that while you are using your hand, your brain is working very fast. But don't forget all the computer things, all the new technologies. They are always, you can use all the techniques as a part of working, not inside your working. And like this. Continues not only Lisbon and Istanbul, but also the Lisbon and all of them until today. We are still working going on for this book research, and maybe I can continue with his words if he wants to say something before, and he always used some years ago. He never said 20 years, 25 years, or because he thinks that some years is enough for him. It's not only the difference between 1 year before or 20 years before. Some years before, some years ago, the idea was writing that book, and the cultural and geographical, historical sequence of three Greek cities, and he always dealing with the human history. And then that was the Lear project in the beginning, and we went to Rio for that process. And he always trying to arrange the things, scientific analysis in the beginning, and then making artistic view while we were working together. And then he always thinking that these three capital cities, three imperial cities, needs intellectual work, and that was the one meeting in 2005. And this is the same with the analogical model. And the model start with this step. And what was the three special sentence while we were starting that book? It was the origin of great urban cultures and the globalization start. He thinks that the globalization starts with trade over the ocean. And South Hemisphere and connection, it means that the Rio. And he has this kind of analogical model. He can explain, I try to explain why he was talking about the world history. And he thinks that the Asia with the Silk Road, Istanbul is the east end, and Portugal, Lisbon is the west end of the continent. And the east end have its own routes, and the routes going to the India, and the west end of the Lisbon, of the continent, it's going to flourish, and all the seeds going to the world. These red, these green points show the how the they reach the ocean to the give the seeds the other continents. And his analogical model also based on the structure of the our book, and it's like a diaphragm of the world. And if we keep this road, sea road, and it will be good things for the next generation. And then he always thinking that the Europe having this strength and strong relations, especially he always, when he couldn't find any pencil and paper, he also used his body to explain everything. And that was the idea he was telling. Portugal and Turkey having the same Mediterranean cultural, social relations. But the strength of the Europe and always having difficulty to be coming together, and the strength and it's becoming of political forces, and the Portugal and Turkey having some difficulties to being together. But if we look at the clocks outside the windows, like Mediterranean, and you can see the, some aspects of this part. And we had the parameters. I don't want to explain all the parameters, but the most important one, the behind the matrix, nothing saying to you. And we talk about similarities. He never mentioned about the differences. He always trying to find the positive way of the ideas. And he always trying to explain how we can find the solutions rather than existing one. And he always trying to create an alternative. And the alternative is always easy to choose. If you don't have any alternatives to solve, you can't solve the problem, only one choices. And then he always said that you need to find the third solution. Even the question mark is black and white, the solution will never be green, will never be gray. You need to find another thing to solve that problem. It means that point of view, creativity, and visual thinking. And if we give some information about this book, we did a lot pages about this similarities. We start making chronology, evolution of the city, administrative division, local images and main physical features. We did a lot, and people, tradition, and fashions. We found a lot of similarities between all these process, and also we deal with the city and regional planning structure. And that was the index. I put all the index here and this. 198 pages, but it's not finished yet. Then I just want to give some examples about how was the idea in the beginning, and the chronology written over the 25 pages. And then if you look at the cities, can you imagine how similar these two cities? And the evolution of the city is the same. We have the same earth disasters, earthquakes, and some fires, and some other difficulties while we made our new plans. And after these new plans, we find also some similarities between the plans and the solutions. And can you say which one is Istanbul, which one is... You remember while we were making the workshop, we went to top of the Sheraton, and that was the Sheraton photo, which I took there, and this is from the Galata Tower. And the light, he was working with the light, like Murat Hoca started with the light, but he was always talking about the lights. Istanbul and Lisbon were the same. And he was trying to make a lot of exhibition, a lot of research, a lot of work with the light, the city. And the main physical features, which one is Istanbul, and which bridge this one, and you can't imagine. And here in the beginning he was telling that this is river, or this is Üsküdar, or river, or Bosphorus. We are always talking about this side and other side. And he had a lot of local physical features, like old time, autumn time, and we did a lot of things by searching the same ages. And as I started in the beginning, Kız Kulesi, he's always saying Kız Kulesi, not Princess Island. He always said Kız Kulesi and the Belém Tower, and they have a relations. Sometimes relations between Galata Kulesi and the Kız Kulesi having love each other, and they have another child waiting in the estuary, in the entrance of the estuary. And lots
Aquários Limpos, Aqueduto.
And as Hilletown, seven Hilletown. We also having some tramways, like tramways. That was the tramways we were find in 1871 or something. These photos are the same, but this is still the same. But we change our tramway lines, and we removed all the tramway lines instead of car invasion. But they had also the same scenario, and like İstiklal Caddesi, and we were similar physical features, but they still have, that was the last time I was there, I took that red one, I think it's 28 for the touristic one,
yeah.
And ours also the same nostalgic tramway. I just remind ourselves, we had this kind of tramway plans. And we have a lot of same street sellers, the same. And these are some pages from the book. And also that I mentioned before, our clothes, the same. And also, again, street fashion and street sellers. And we like music, we like dancing, we like being together. And also we had see both of us, and it's very important in the city center, both cities can have their beach. And he always mentioned that it was a very special thing if you have Bosphorus, if you have river, you need to swim while you are walking, you need to swim while you are working, and it was very important for the city being together, not only the shopping malls, not only the design places, but also a city can able to give all of opportunities to create yourself. And then he always coming the same time with the Erbans. We were used to see him Erbans time and so Dutch. But we are still searching about the differences. And if you have some information about the differences, Lisbon and Istanbul, we'll try again, and we'll try to continue to work on it. And this book, I hope, finish. But he always say, this book will not end. This is volume one. You need to be work on volume two, volume three. And then, thank you for listening.
Tabii 5 saatte hocam anlatmak çok zor. Anlatmaya çalıştım.
İngilizce.
Okay. I prepared a very small speech about Kusura book. It is very difficult to say everything about the professor in a short time, but I wanted to put in some important characteristics of our professor. First of all, he was our teacher. He taught many things, but one important thing is he taught us the third solution. So which makes our life very easy. With the third solution approach, it's able to, it makes us to think outside the box, so we can be creative and we can be free thinkers. And Kosovo is a free thinker, I think. He believed in poor people. was a planner who needed always people around to discuss and create ideas. He believed that being together meant getting the power. He connected people from all the countries, occupations, and all the ages. The young and children, women and men, and black or white. And he's able to do that. He's a scientist and also he's an artist. He has very strong analytical approach. He made very good synthesis. He knew techniques very well and he likes number. And he also likes to play with number. But he used these techniques and numbers in a different way, more softly way. So we can say that he was a kind of humanist, a kind of romantic and artist. He has an approach who combined different things. For example, he combined intuition and reasoning. He combined aesthetics and cost and moral belief and functionality. So he created an equilibrium with concrete data and subjective feelings, which is very important in decision making. And he's a kind of professor, he's a kind of teacher who combines all the things, and it's an expression. It's an expression of scientific thinking and artistic thinking. So the circle is strong. His way of thinking, I think, very well. So maybe you talked about this is Franz Mahler model. It's a sustainable city, which has green parts and which is polycentric, and he combines the greens and green things. So he can just sketch the small data details and can create a model or theory from that. He is a kind of number acrobatic. Number. He made acrobacy with numbers. So he wants to, he likes you to draw with numbers, and drawings are, I think, his language. He looked ahead, he never complained the situation, never. He tried to find also new ways, new thinking to life, to make life better. He appreciated the past, but nevertheless he looked ahead. He did not meet the day with the data details, but deal with the concepts and ideas. He was an adventurer, not because he traveled to different places. He traveled among new ideas. He looked at the world excitedly and curiously. He approached excited and curious not only to new places, but all people, young, old, and new children. Professor was a voice, but rather he was a friend of the world. He was a friend of people, a friend of trees, animals, mountains, living and non-living being of the world. He was a kind of planner who saw, felt, understood the world, and tried to change it in a good manner. So, he memorialized